Okay, so yesterday, what did I get up to? I got up the thread pool. I did add tests afterwards, or a test that I can seems to be okay. Now I need to go back to resources material. I need to drill down from material down to the fragment descriptor for now, I believe. Because that's still, yeah, that's that. So one of the first things I need to do if I want to drill down to it for the fragment descriptor is I first of all need to change this to be specifically graphics. So like this. Now I used to have, originally I did have the idea of like this. But I'm kind of against this now because I don't have good ability to delete things when I change out a shader. And I want them to be, if you change a fragment descriptor, I would also be able to change all the materials that use that. So you can like upgrade, easily upgrade, let's say, material type with a new option. Like all the materials that used it move up. And then you can select whether or not to upgrade some or other, something like that. Which is super far forward into the future, but hey, that's what I do. So first things first, I'm going to actually back that up, because this needs to be across everything. Oh, fragment descriptor. Like that. Very nice. Yeah, for the moment. This will also have to be changed up to use the handle system soon-ish, but not quite yet. So first of all, we're going to, okay, there's a lot of things that changed here, so I need to do this first as an atomic commit. You know what? No, we will actually change it entirely up to that. Fragment descriptor for the moment. To do all that. Whoop. Yeah. And the pool will be changed over to. Okay, we got that out of the way. Now, one of the things we go back down to resource, we're going to add fragment descriptor. This will have many of the same things as material. Fragment descriptor. We don't actually use that right now. Yes, we'll take this. Need to export. We need the load state. Yes. We also need these types. Yes. good old-fashioned Fragment Descriptor. It's a class, actually. Public and private members. When unloading a fragment descriptor, we can just pass it on to the subitems. No, we need to wait and delay it by a couple turns. There's no ways around that, actually. I'd rather be safe and just do it in a delayed fashion like all the others, now that I think about it. These are the same. Yes. That and that. Oh yeah, I gotta do that as well. Nasty bit of business that. Quest, resource load. Some thinking. Actually, I shouldn't think. That's the thing that's brought in. It has to be. We'll have a struct type. Oh, there we go. Virtual this. It's defaulted. This is the descriptor, much like this. So then this one would just turn into like just plain old that. And Clang already broke. Save it. Reload it. Come on, live. There we go. very similar. Now, I want to be able to kind of template this a little bit. The problem with templating is I'll probably lose these strings. Unless I change that. Whatever, I'll figure it out later. Once I have at least two or three for entropy, then I'll actually know what I'm doing. Or have a better, context. I don't want to pin myself in or eliminate options too early in the process. Again, which is why, again, I'm willing to remake a bunch of things as necessary as we go down. Increment use, decrement, get use. Because this is request resource load. This is pretty much all bog standard stuff I can probably change up to be templated for sure. That means I require the fragment descriptor loader. This is very similar to this, isn't it? It really is. Again, pretty much the same. Almost the same. Practically all of it is going to be the same. So we will do that. I just may as well just copy it. It's the same stuff. Again, this is like, okay, you know what? I'm just gonna do a copy paste job for the moment, since it's practically the same. Frag pool, the async jobs. This is interesting. Still a lot of errors cropping up. Let's just start whacking them back down. I need the fragment descriptor because I need the data subtype. Okay, this becomes P graphics frag descriptor. Okay. Let's add it to here. Okay. Again, very similar thing. Frag descriptor loader. The fragment descriptor pool. Process load requests with frag shader. Goes like that. Anything else? Okay. So now what I'm going to do is rather than make sure it builds at this point, which it does not. Now material needs to change to be this type instead. Don't want that anymore. Actually, no, I do want that for that. So I can export that again through the material. What happens instead in material loader is rather than us creating it here, we're passing that in. So what we have is we're going to pass that in. That's the thing we're using to load stuff in now. Yeah. Don't want the shader anymore. Instead, load resource. Equals that. Load it in, we got it, so we're gonna throw that in instead. And process load requests now takes in this type instead. You are correct. Oh, I changed it in. Nope, 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 no, no, no. Wait, hold on a second. Wrong one. I'll change it in material loader, not fragment. Descriptor loader. No wonder I was so confused about this. Then I go back down to material loader. This is now fixed up. All right, now it still is that. Cool, but I still need the descriptor. Don't need that. Don't need that. No. Jeez, I don't need that. That goes away. I don't think there's a way to tell whether or not it's actually got something. Checks if a valid target is contained. Okay, yes, there is a way. Not that. Or can I just do like a... Yes, that. Return that. Return whether that's something. Otherwise, I can't clear it. Maybe that works. Okay, we do this. See if it works, because what I need to do is I need to change up the material loader to actually check if something okay, not great. Right, because the material is supposed to increment the that type. So we go in. To the descriptor loader. Or is it material loader? Do 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 do. We come down here. Okay, this is not as. It's not great. This can cause a lock in a multi-threaded environment if I get enough items. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna have to. Because this would start the new frag descriptor loading process itself. Whatever about the reference? I need to do something about that as well. There's a definition stage. I need to do like a load and definition. On the definition, that's where we would normally do. Decrement the use, and we decrement the ref as well at the same time. Decrement use. Okay, material and fragment descriptor do have active uses and active reference checks for on exit. Okay. It's kind of getting there. It's not exactly great, especially with shader being kind of sitting out in the cold right now. Currently, so it'll be switched, split between two, it'll be like, not great. Has a negative use count. Great. Why? Decrement use count. So this, it's used through material, not through its own existence. Inching closer, inching closer. Okay, so at the fragment stage, we'd have shaders. So let's close this stuff. Let's close that. Close that. Close that. I don't have shader resources quite yet. Although, again, they'll be much in the same vein as before. Okay, we'll go back to, again, the basically the same thing as almost. I want this repeatable pattern. Sorry, where's this? Oh, that's the graphics one. Don't need the fragment descriptor. Don't know why I shared pointers. Okay, that's a few things I needed to do. Material F, we got a frag descriptor. Do that, rebase couple. 8, okay, material. Okay, I actually need to go way back. 16. Fix up these. Okay. Can also remove that. Whatever. I won't move that one quite yet. Packed shader. they want to rename this type from source data to like definition data. But we'll do that later. Again, must material shaders last. And inevitably, this would also be the same thing. So right now in this branch, pretty sure I'm loading in the shader, yeah, manually. Get shader like that, graphics shader. Yeah, it's not that, it's just a handle type. Okay. Okay, hold, whoa. That. These are the same. Don't need this though. Hold on a second. Did I do that? It's like saying P material in the fragment descriptor loader. Yes, it does. Whoops. problem right now being that I'm both defining and loading at the same time. I need to split the definition and the loading apart. Dang it. Fragment descriptor, and this, fix up those. Okay, back to shader loader. These are basically the same, except obviously that. We don't bring that in. These types come on in. We export. Shader. Yeah. Graphics type defs. One thing I do require is for creation, destruction of these things. Shader loader. Where'd it go? Where'd I put it? This is already brought in. This will be almost the same. processing of unloads. This is actually going to have a real effect here. Actually, should also have an effect here, where mfrag, actually, no, hold on, data. Well, this is being deleted afterwards anyway, so there's actually nothing to do here. Okay, there's more I gotta do to figure out. But here, anyways, data. So that'll probably destroy the shaders. When we where was I? These request. So we already got processing. Now we need to go through the request ones. Again, basically the same. Then we have the load resource process, which will be, I'm not entirely sure how to do it for shaders. Don't have this. This stuff. I mean, for reference, I can actually just move around shared pointers, really, couldn't I? It'd be almost the same. So I probably will actually change to that. And then the only one we have is for use counts, which we'd have to keep track of. Okay, for the moment, I need to bring in... I will need to bring in the loading here, but for the moment, what I'm going to do... The shader. For the moment. So we may not be able to get rid of this in a moment. We'll hard code in frag shader just for this, just for the moment. So I can figure out. Or refigure out the shader loading from file. It's not a move, right? That's not a move. Where do I even use this anymore? I don't even think I do. I must use it somewhere. Or no, I use it in the other branch for the model and mesh stuff, yes. Yes, and it's not that, it's upload context now. Okay, we're close. We're getting close. Application CPP should have code for frag shader. This stuff. Yes. I need to copy this. for the moment. This is the stuff we use to load the shader. The fragment shader, that is. Direct definition? That is good. I just came up with an idea for resource management, or loading, I should say. The definition loading mechanism. But I gotta finish this first. Whoops. Where did all this stuff go? Supposed to have all of this. Like that. Auto shader code equals that. We need to include bunch of issues. Why? Faux shader constant accept return data dot shader. Cannot initialize return of that. Oh. Yes, that is not done yet either. Okay, let us see how this goes once I hook it into Fragment Descriptor Loader. This needs to be... Okay, we'll just do the shader stuff first, minus this part. So this... Okay, fragment descriptor. First of all, this needs to... This is another fix up. file. Okay, now we need to get to fragment shader or fragment descriptor. Okay, hold on a second. Does it completely die if I run it? It shouldn't. No. Okay. Build. It's an SO file. So it is shared. So I have the exports going correctly. Fragment descriptor. It takes this and takes in a one of these types as well. Nothing to do here, but we have everything to do in here. So once we unload this, then we're saying, hey, if data.pshader not equal null pointer, because we can have a null pointer shader because obviously it's either a blank data that we're trying to unload, or it's a fragment descriptor that's attached for shadow rendering, depth buffer rendering. So it doesn't actually create a fragment. It's just, but it still has the fragment descriptor because it needs like depth and culling information and all that stuff. It's as strange as that would be. So. And then we'd also have to destroy the faux graphics fragment descriptor when I get it here, when it's destroyable and changeable and stuff like that. To change this up to no longer take in this type. Process load requests. Don't take in shader. Don't take in shader. Yeah, that's Okay. Oh, crap. Not exactly sure where I'm getting a shader from right now. We've got 1 hour 20. Been speeding on long on this one. Till this roadblock. Okay, I'll pause it. I'm gonna grab a drink and think about this. Okay. Ha. That's just okay. Graphic shader. I need to add it temporarily to the fragment descriptor itself. Temporary, temporary, temporary. So what we're going to do is application. We're not even using this anymore, so we can fragment slash material. Get rid of that. Shader. Okay, shader loader. This is pretty much still here. Go to material loader. No, not material loader, fragment. Descriptor loader here. Now, if whoop. Okay, let's say tfrag descriptor not equal null pointer and tfrag descriptor sorry. Get load state not equal to resource load state loaded. Then we need to re-add and then return. So we're not done here. Otherwise, yeah, we return it to whatever the expected value was. Whatever it was. Yes, precisely what it was before. It equals that. we add ourselves to quest load. Which is this again? We'll just requeue it basically while we wait for the shader to be loaded. And in here, sorry, no. Yeah, I may as well put it in here then, actually. That makes sense. Increment use count. I need to slightly figure out how I'm doing the use counts. A little bit better than this. This is a bit janky. Unless I increment. Wait, hold on. What? Oh, yeah. Fragment descriptor. What? Oh, I gotta change that name. So one thing I need to do is P. Stage that, frag descriptor fix up. Is there anywhere else in here that says material? That one. frag the fix up. Okay, now we're here again. Okay, yeah, and then we need to remove this again. Like that. This is... if p frag descriptor p shader, we need a p frag descriptor p shader get shader, otherwise it's null handle. Now I'm expecting this, something in my logic is going to make this just absolutely fall flat on its face. Okay, maybe not. Okay, please tell me at least we're going into this where we have to go into here. We are re-adding it. Right? Because it's not already loaded. I know that. Yeah. And we set him back to whatever he was, which was unloaded. Okay, this time he didn't load up. Kind of like half the time loading up. Why didn't he load up this time? Sleep for a second. Between me leaving here. Oh no, because it's because I paused in here. He came back through the thread. Because he was already still in the load state. Now if I do it. Oh. Okay. Let's get this started up a bit faster. Okay. Not too bad. I need to really look at the dependency use counts a lot more. But okay. Until I get a mechanism for loading from external files or something, until I get a non-hardcoded version of loading, this is as good as it's going to get. So let's put this in what I have right now. Then gonna be loaded from although it is hard-coded currently. One, two, three, four. Okay. Sorry, what? Oh, there we go. Okay. think I'll call it there for the moment. Next time I'll see if I can start switching these over from hard-coded loaded values to some back to the loading from file, that is. This is most probably the YAML that I kind of had for a little while, then I kind of had to abandon this stuff. This will come back, and it will come back to haunt me, and it will be nasty. All right, cheers.